can't buy. It resides between my eyes. Walked through the fire, came out better on the other side. See, life's like a beach if you find the sand. And right now, I'm feeling like $100,000.
You are listening to Inspired Insider with your host, Dr. Jeremy Wise.
Live from the Sweet Snack Show. Dr. Jeremy Weiss here. We're live from the Sweet and Snack Show. I am here with Pop Daddy Pretzels, and you guys have popcorn too, Mark, and made in Michigan, right? So tell me about the origins of the company when you first started.
Well, started off as an addiction to popcorn, really, and we started, my family and I quit eating microwave popcorn. We started making our own, we were making popcorn with different oils and different kernels. And then our neighbors started asking us for it and making it for birthday parties and graduation parties.
What did you find with the oils? What did you like most?
The olive oil was definitely by far the best. We enjoyed it and it has great health benefits. And then, and so at that point we ended up with two large popcorn machines in our basement, and we were taking my kids to farmers markets and we were selling it at farmers markets.
And how were you packaging it at the time?
With a scoop and a table sealer, a hand sealer, essentially, yeah. So
I'm sure it didn't look beautiful like this, but...
No, we've had several evolutions.
Your kids are like, okay, slave labor, start putting the labels on.
Yeah, absolutely, absolutely. So, yeah, so that's how it all started, and the business opportunity came when I had switched careers. It wasn't a great move, and we had this business basically 5% started in my basement, and then we... I went to a couple retailers and they said, we love it, let's give it a try. And so we went and got licensed in a regular facility. We shared 1,200 square feet with four other companies and went from there.
So it started off farmer's market though. So what was that experience like as far as selling at the farmer's market? Because I imagine it's pretty cool getting like face-to-face customer feedback.
Oh yeah, so it was great. We still do show, we do street fairs all the time still, but that's how we test all of our new products. And so, you know, at the farmers markets, that's how we knew we had something special. That the same people came back every week to buy it. And we're like, wow, this is going really well.
How was the transition from that to, you said, like a larger facility? What did the larger facility look like?
So we started off with one suite where we are in an industrial park. Grew out of that rather quickly. And we now have the suite next to us. We took over. It was nervous switching because you go from sharing 1,200 square feet to 5,000 square feet.
And
it's pretty empty when you move in and you hope you can fill it. But, you know, you have confidence and you feel like you have a right business plan and the right retailers to support you and go from there.
What are the favorite flavors? Personally, the garlic parmesan's mine. What are the favorites in the popcorn and then in the pretzels?
So popcorn, the original, is it's three ingredients. It's olive oil, sea salt, red corn. That's it. It's my personal favorite. It's our best seller of all of our items. It's just very clean. And then I love the mustard pretzel. It's
mustard.
Yeah, it's straight yellow mustard. It's not a honey mustard or honey onion. It's just really good.
And then where can people get the product?
So we're in two Kroger divisions. You can get it at all Kroger Michigan stores or Kroger Indiana stores and all Meijer stores, best bet. Also available on Amazon as well.
All right. So for people out there, where else do you want it, in case they're listening?
everywhere. We want to be everywhere, absolutely. But, yeah, there's a bunch of great retailers out there, specialty stores, and just a lot of opportunities. We have a product for everybody, for every consumer.
What's your favorite story, Mark, about getting it out? I mean, it's not easy to get product out there into the market. Yeah. What's your favorite story of how you got it out there?
Well, that's a hard question. I mean, you know, we're very grateful for, you know, the best story is the beginning, right? So, you know, I went and asked two retailers that I had relationships with from a previous career, and they both gave me a three-store test.
That's awesome.
And so I started with six stores, essentially, and my family and I sampled and worked every weekend, you know, sampling our product at those stores. And then eventually they gave us all their stores, and then some of the bigger retailers took notice at that point. So, you know, I'll never forget the first six-store route we had, and I guess that's my greatest memory of getting started.
Yeah, I love that story. Yeah. What's tricks for sampling? I remember I interviewed some, like, Ron Popeil, right, infomercial king, and those guys were all street salesmen. I mean, they would be on the market selling. Yeah. So what were some of the things that worked to attract people and get people to try the product or interacting?
Yeah, so we say hello, we address everybody first without asking them to try our product. We say, hello, how you doing?
Yeah.
And then if we get a good reaction, then we go from there. So we always never just jump at somebody and say, hey, try our popcorn.
And they should anyway.
Yeah, they should. And it's an easy thing to get people to try, really. So
where should people go online to check you out?
PopDaddyPopcorn.com. And then from there, there's a direct link to our Amazon store.
So how did you come up with the name, Pop Daddy Popcorn?
So, not a great story. I asked my wife and kids. Yeah, no. I asked my wife and kids to, you know, run through some names. And, you know, we got a name. We're going
to
create a label and the logo. And I was driving
home. It has a ring to it.
Yeah, it does. And I was driving home one day, and I was running through names in my head, and it popped in my head. And I called my wife, and I said, what do you think? She said, that's it.
That's it.
And that's how we came up with it, yeah.
All right.
No great story.
Pop Daddy Popcorn, check it out. Thank you, Mark.
Hey,
fantastic.
Appreciate it. What I got, you can't buy. It resides between my eyes. Walked through the fire, came out better on the other side. Like a beach if you find the sand. And right now I'm feeling like 100 grand.